got to the top.
Wild on the racetrack.
You can be enemies on the racetrack, but when somebody gets sick, everybody sticks together.
I can just respect the fact that he wants to go out and do what he wants to do, and I want to be there to help him do it.
What's the perfect ending here?
Sponsored by Peterson Plumbing, a family-run business with a history of competing, winning, and giving back.
It is race night in East Moline, Illinois. Final preps are underway here. The fans are starting to pack into the stands. You know, most of the fans are rooting for one driver, maybe one team. But on this particular night, many of them are rooting for one guy and his team. We show you why in the heart of the story.
So Doug, tell me, what's racing mean in your life?
Well, we've raced our entire lives. I grew up riding three-wheelers as a kid, and then about 10 years old, started getting interested in racing. And a friend of mine, TJ Timmerman, started racing dirt bikes. So we went to watch, and he couldn't shift or use a clutch, so I got to ride his bike. And from there on, it was just forever.
Like most racers, one challenge often leads to another.
Well, you went from two wheels to four. Yeah. What was that transition like?
Well, I thought it would be real easy because you couldn't fall over, but turns out it's a little tougher than it looked. But
you can do worse than fall over.
You can do worse than fall over, yeah.
But after racking up a string of feature wins, about 50 to date, he was about to experience a fall of sorts that would change his life. A slick spot by a small stream in Bluegrass, Iowa, changed everything.
We had aluminum drive shaft and they made us take it out. So we put the steel drive shaft in and it didn't have the clearance in the yoke. And I was kind of babysitting it, thought I could handle it and come up through the car. And I went through my arm, spun my arm on a couple of times and spun right up into my chin and my chest. And it was about 7 surgeries over 5 days and 21 days in intensive care and things like that. But we got through it.
Working on his car and we got a phone call that Doug was in an accident. And we jumped in the truck and we literally beat Doug to the hospital. And when they brought him in, it was just, you know, it was wild. He got back into it, you know, healed up, and it's just one of those things where you look at him, you're like, that's the guy right there.
But after months of recovery, that guy was just not the same. He would never be the same. So after a few more races, he put the brakes on a career he loved. But you know what they say about racers? After nearly 2 decades, Doug is not done yet.
What's getting you back in now?
My older boys are 28 and 27 right now, and I got a 4.5-year-old. And my son Aaron, who's 27, says, we're out golfing one day, and he says, you know what really sucks? He says, me and Ryan are in all these checkered flag picks, and Caleb will never be in one. And I'm telling you, it just lit that fire. And I had no inkling. I didn't even want to drive. For 19 years, I mean, I like race cars, I like going to races, but I thought, nothing.
And there is another driving force, one that he admits his skills on the track can't outmaneuver.
You're in another battle. Do you mind telling us about that?
Not a bit. About a little over two years ago, I was diagnosed with, I went to a doctor and they told me I had testicular cancer, but my PSA levels were real high. And it turned out I had prostate cancer. So we did 17 weeks worth of chemo and radiation. And that was probably the toughest battle of my life, but we're still standing here, so.
So you determined to beat that too?
I don't know if nobody ever beats cancer.
Determined to drive, he reached out to a boyhood friend and motocross competitor, and things kicked into gear.
4 or 5 times throughout this process, it just didn't look like it was going to happen. And bringing Junior on board has just been, I can't even tell you what that has happened there. I mean, I've known the guy since I've been 14 years old, and it is just uncanny how many things we have in common and how much we're alike, and I guess you call it chemistry. But he brings an awful lot to the table, I can tell you that.
Junior, a soft-spoken master of the craft, both on the track and in the shop, a national champion who knows what it's like to compete and win.
Been building motors for over 20 years now.
What is it about racing that sort of gets in the blood? I see when people talk about racing, they're really passionate about it. What is it?
You know, I've took to it at a young age. Once you start it, you know, the adrenaline and just the process of becoming good at what you do or trying to become good at what you do. So we never really had this bond that we've kind of formed here in the last few months. He came to me 3 or 4 months ago and he was going through cancer, and came to me with the idea of helping him out with suspension. The idea of building his motors, nothing like, it was started off as me helping him with his shocks, and that's how it started. And it's just completely turned into a completely different deal. You know, now it's, I'm building his motor, I'm building shocks, it's just really gone a lot farther than that.
And you were able to pull a lot of people together, so you have even competitors are now coming together.
Well, I had no idea that so many people in my industry, meaning the motocross industry, were so involved in stock car racing, and some of those guys have really gotten behind me that I had no idea they were involved in that area. And it's been cool to see everybody step up and help, and really to get him back out there on the track.
His competitors now teammates with a common goal.
You can be competitors on the track, you can be enemies on the racetrack, but when somebody gets sick, everybody sticks together.
What do you think of this, everyone come together for Doug?
It's emotional. It really is. No. But we're doing it for him. I don't want to sound like a baby, but that's why we're here.
We wait on a closed track that friends arrange just for Doug.
In a car on a track for the first time in almost 20 years. Yeah. What do you think about that?
I'm glad I'm here. I want to be here for it. I wish we wasn't doing this kind of secretly so he could come up by himself, because there's probably a lot of people would like to be here right now.
But on this day, until he runs for the first time here, only the team necessary to get the test run in, and his youngest son, his little boy, will watch his father drive.
This is what he wants to do. This is his last goal in life, is to go out this way.
And how does it make you feel to be able to help him get that goal?
I'm here for him. I'm proud. My whole family is.
As we shoot a couple of other cars in test runs, word comes in. Doug's car is having problems. The scramble is on for mechanics and parts. Can they make it all happen? And then, a couple of hours later, the truck and trailer arrive. 19 years of waiting. Down to this.
How are you feeling?
Ready to go, buddy. Ready to go. All right, it's a long 3 days, man. Yeah. Right up till just now.
You got any room for a passenger?
I'll give you a ride.
For a lap or two before
taking it. That's just not how I roll.
It's just not how I roll. And then the moment so many have worked for.
What do you think?
What's the perfect ending here?
It's already happened. It's already happened, but we'll make sure we get the rest of it too.
Enjoy this story? Subscribe, hit the like button, and share it with friends. The Heart of the Story with Gary Metivier. New stories every week.